Hey everyone, it is Jane. I am in a different spot today. I had to do some little swatches for the website and I thought, well, why don't I turn the video on, say hello to you guys, and we could do the swatches together. But holding the camera, selfie style, just don't turn my arms. See, I've sort of set it up, but who knows, right? So I'm just going to swing the camera around. See. And let me just show you some of the properties of the Pinpoint Paint Pens and how to get them working and just general tips for paint pens. So there's two ingredients inside every paint pen. You've got the binder and the pigment itself. And these two things need to be combined to get the end color and to get the best result. That's why you always need to shake your paint pens. And I'm showing you this color and the Pinpoint paint pens. I've done a clear barrel, clear nib, everything's clear. All components are just about clear in this pen. So you can see what's going on and you can see when the ink is mixed properly, because that's just so important. Inside's actually a little mixing ball as well. Sometimes when you first start to shake the pen, you might not even hear the mixing ball. That's because it's sitting in the pigment and they're shaking even more. So cap on, very important, and shake, shake, shake. Good exercise. And this is why we always say the best way to store your markers, especially markers that you have to mix up like this, horizontally, because it makes that mixing process so much faster. Because you've got the pigment spread out long ways, and the mixing ball is then going to be rolling up and down on top of that pigment, and it will get it all mixed up into the binder, and you'll just be off to the races so much quicker than if you store them tip down, which you could get leaking, or tip up. It just takes longer to get them activated. So I've got my pens there from the night before. I love drawing with the Pinpoint paint pens, especially when I'm watching a movie. So that's why I've got them set up in my lounge room here, and my sofa has that nice flat armrest so that I can put my art supplies there. But even if I've got them horizontally and I don't use them for a bit, I'm still going to need to shake them up. Another little tip is put them all in your cute cube and shake them all at once. So I've designed the cute cube so that all of the paint pens, the Pinpoint paint pens, can fit in the smaller of the cubes. And I give the whole lot a shake. I could put all of them in there and give them a shake, but I've already got them arranged in rainbow formation there on my armrest. But I could do that. Now these ones have been sitting nib up. And I just want to, same thing, I'm just showing you that they all fit in there, plus a little bit of room for more that might come along. Spoiler alert. But you can see very easily if I pull a few out, how they're not mixed up. I'm going to have to mix all of these. So my choice here is I just shake the whole lot. Always make sure you've got the lids on everything, because you can, once they're primed, the ink can fly out of the top. Believe me, I've done that and I have worn the ink. And I've already primed all of my pens that I'm going to be using. So I'm going to insert another little bit of footage here from another live broadcast where I'm using a new pen. It's even sporting a little bit of blue tack from the photo shoot I did with them. So on the top of the lid, on the top of the cap, is a little dip. And you can just prime your pen on that. You can do it on paper as well, but you can just do this. This degasses the pen. It just lets any air out first, and it allows the ink to come flowing down into the nib. Sometimes you might have a little bit of that unmixed ink in the nib, and that's what you're going to get that comes out of your paint pens first. So it'll be a little bit clearer. So that's why working on a little bit of scrap paper first is a good idea. Then you'll get the lovely opaque ink that you've mixed by shaking, coming through, and happy days. And on my lap here, I've already started some paint swatches, well, paint pen swatches, and the name. So I needed to do this for the website so people could see the color. And I'm just going around adding a few little details so you can also see how fine the line is with this beautiful Japanese solid nylon tip. And this is the same type of tip that was in my beloved favorite Sharpie extra fine white paint pens that have been long discontinued. And I have been searching for that type of tip for ages for paint pens. If you follow me in my groups or in my workshops, you know all about this. I love the 0.7mm tip. It's great for drawing, but also for writing and for lettering. And of course, then you've got the beautiful acrylic ink, which dries permanently and waterproof, just like a normal acrylic paint, and has all of those features, just with this really beautiful control as well. In fact, they're great with acrylic paint because you can do your broader strokes with your acrylics and then any fine details or drawing on top of them or on top of watercolor or any other art supply. You've then got this fine control with the qualities of, that was a happy dance, I think, with the qualities of the acrylic ink. And in the matte set of Pinpoint Paint Pens, you've got that, you can see the colors there, but beautiful array of brights, of pastels, and of neutrals. So you've got colors that you can use for faces that are, let's say, more traditional or realistic colors. Of course, you can mix the different colors as well, one over the other. And it's just got that. And you've even got a few darker, shadowy colors. But, oh, I just adore drawing with them. On the left-hand side of my page, this is a very common occurrence in my journals. I do my swatching in my art journals because, oh, my art supplies are just such a joy, and they're part of my art life. Even before I started designing them, this is a very common occurrence. Swatches on one side, and on the other side where I'm cleaning nibs or testing them, getting them ready to rock and roll, that's sort of my freeform session, and a lot of interesting things usually happen on the left side of the page where I'm just doing mark making, a little bit of drawing, this and that. And because of the beautiful quality and opaqueness of the ink, look at it on black paper. This is in my dark arts journal. And let's use the metallic set. There's 11 metallics. Let's use them on the dark paper. They work great on lighter paper, but they really look terrific on dark paper. Oh, and on my website, you will also find swatch charts for the metallic set, the matte set as standalone sets, but also a combined chart with all of the colors as well. They are downloadable PDFs. And again, I've already primed all of my paint pens the night before, and you also saw me shaking them all together, so they're already ready for fun, ready for drawing. So I'm doing some swatching by drawing out little symbols for each of the names. The names are things like Crystal Slipper, Clock Strikes 12, which is a beautiful gunmetal metallic. Crystal Slipper is a silver metallic. This gorgeous green metallic is the Great Oz. And just to prove that I am the fastest drawer on the whole planet, I'm just, jokes, I'm just going to speed this up. We've also got Emerald City, which is a beautiful, bright turquoise green. Then we've got the gorgeous You Shall Go to the Ball, a beautiful Cinderella Fairy Godmother blue, magic wand blue. We also have Fairy Godmother herself, which is a gorgeous purple. And because the metallics, they're not just one color, you know, the color shifts as you're using them. That's the beauty of them. The beautiful deep red is Cinderella Kiss. Then we have Ruby Slippers, which is more of a bright red, perfect for her slippers and beautiful to add a little bit of shine to lips. We have Medal of Courage, which is more of an orange, brassy brown, but it's more on the orange side. And of course, the colors change depending on what you're creating on as well, but just because of the nature of metallic inks. And then we also have the Pumpkin Carriage, which is a warm orange yellow, gold. And then we end with Prince Charming, which is a gold. And we symbolize Prince Charming with a crown. And that is all of the 36 Pinpoint Paint Pen colors. You can buy them as sets. There's the matte set, the metallic set. You can buy them as a bundle where the gorgeous little cute cubes are included as well. And you can get the white paint pens as a set on their own as well, because we just need more white paint pens. And you can find all of the Pinpoint Paint Pens and the cute cubes at janedavenport.com, where we send out art supplies to happy artists all over the world every day, and we love doing it.